Donald Trump had a $1 million judgment against him for hiring illegal aliens. You know what he's doing right now in Florida? He brings in hundreds of foreign workers instead of hiring Americans. Sir, with all respect, Donald Trump is deceiving. He is playing you for a chump. And ask yourself two questions. Why is it that the mainstream media so desperately wants Donald Trump to be the Republican nominee? And why is it that John Boehner supports Donald Trump? Do you agree with John Boehner?
No.
Do you agree with Nancy Pelosi?
The thing is, they don't agree with everybody, but I believe in Trump. He's the only one that's going to put us where we need to be.
So
what are you going to do about the Second Amendment?
Okay, great question.
What are you going to do about the Second Amendment?
Yeah. All right, I have defended the Second Amendment in front of the Supreme Court of the United States. Do you know that Donald Trump supported Bill Clinton's national ban on some of the most popular firearms in America? And that is a fact. You go read his book where he said, I agree with Bill Clinton. In fact, he said, I hate guns. That's a quote from Donald Trump. I have spent 20 years fighting to defend the Second Amendment. And I'll tell you this, sir. If Donald Trump ever becomes president, he has said on the Supreme Court he's going to cut a deal with Chuck Schumer. He said that in two debates ago, which means he's going to put a liberal on the Supreme Court. He's going to take away your Second Amendment right. There is a reason why Gun Owners of America has endorsed me in this campaign, because I've defended the Second Amendment my whole life, while Donald Trump is a New York liberal who will take away your Second Amendment rights. This man is lying to you, and he's taking advantage of you. And I would encourage you, sir, I appreciate your being out here speaking. If I were Donald Trump, I wouldn't have come over and talked to you. I wouldn't have shown you that respect. In fact, you know what I would have done? I would have told the folks over there, go over and punch those guys in the face. That's what Donald does to protesters. I think a candidate is campaigning to work for you. Okay, stop. What word did I say was a lie?
About Donald telling people to punch people.
Okay, but let me ask you, sir. Just go home and Google Donald punch in the face protesters. And at his rallies, look, this is on national television. You can watch the facts of him standing at the podium saying, punch that guy in the face. I mean, in fact, he says, I'll pay your legal fees when you punch him in the face. And there's a problem. Listen, Donald Trump has accused everyone in this race of being a liar. Donald cannot tell the truth in 1 minute.
You'll find out tomorrow.
So,
and I don't want you.
Well, sir, you are entitled to have your rights, but I'll tell you this. Sir, America is a better country
without you.
Thank you for those kind sentiments. Let me point out, I have treated you respectfully the entire time. And a question that everyone here should ask.
Are you Canadian?
Do you want your kids repeating the words of Donald Trump? Would you be proud if your kids came and yelling and insulting? And let me give you an example of Donald's problems with the truth. Yesterday, he was on national television. He was asked about his support from Mike Tyson, a convicted rapist. And his response is, Ted says Tyson's a rapist. That's why we call him Lion Ted. Mike Tyson was convicted by a jury of his peers, served 3 years in prison for rape here in the state of Indiana, and yet Donald screamed, it's a lie to say Mike Tyson is a racist. Sir, facts matter. Truth
you are
matters.
You carpet bomb women and children, huh?
Now, that's actually interesting. You say carpet bomb women and children.
Those are your words.
No, actually.
I added the women and children, because that's what you're going to be doing with your carpet bomb.
But sir, let me respond to you. It's interesting that you added women and children, because your candidate, Donald Trump, came out and said he would order our military to kill the women and children, the wives and children of terrorists, which is a war crime. When he was asked in the debate, what about when soldiers don't want to commit a war crime and murder women and children? He's the one who said women and children. He said, I will tell them to do it and they will obey me. I'll tell you, anyone who served in the armed services, a president who thinks he's going to order American soldiers to commit war crimes, is a president who doesn't respect the fighting men and women of this country. What I said is we're going to carpet bomb ISIS, we're going to target the terrorists, take out their infrastructure, take out their command and control, take out their oil refineries. Nobody would target women and children except for a bully like Donald Trump. Sir,
that's right.
I respect your right to speak, but I'm also going to say in America, we are a nation that is better than anger and insults and cursing and rage. And I believe the people of Indiana have a common sense, good judgment.
Woo,
that we want real solutions.